Hey everyone, this is Nick here again, and for all my museum friends out there, if you do research or evaluation in a place like a museum, a zoo, or aquarium, you're probably familiar with a method that we use pretty often called timing and tracking, which is basically unobtrusive observation of visitors going through a space, how they use a space, how they walk through a space, what they attend to, all the different exhibits, the signs, the graphics, the objects, all of those different things are part of timing and tracking. And one of the most basic pieces of information we get from timing and tracking is total stay time or dwell time. So what was the minimum stay time for a person? What was the maximum stay time for a person? And often we look at the average time or the median stay time as well. And so this is a really cool visual right here that you see on your screen. This is called a bee swarm plot or a jitter plot. And basically every single one of those blue dots equals one person. So instead of a bar chart that just aggregates everything, and just maybe I would do a bar chart of this mean or average dwell time at 22 minutes and 22 seconds or 26 seconds, this gives us a little bit more information. It tells us what each person, how long each person in my sample stayed. And in this case, I tracked 50 people through an exhibit recently. And you can see the minimum stay time that I tracked was 3 minutes. The maximum was 52 minutes. And the median the average stay time was 22 minutes and 26 seconds. And you can see that by this beautiful orange marker bar right here. Now this is all done in Microsoft Excel and it's all built into Excel with just a couple of little brute force text boxes. So these annotations right here, the minimum dwell time, that's just a text box that I inserted and I added on top of it. Same thing with the maximum. And then same thing with this little legend right here I just kind of inserted a circle and a text box and made that the legend. Now there are definitely ways that you can embed those types of things into the chart as well. I just didn't do that for this time because there was no purpose. But if you had a chart that needed to be updated all the time, that could be a reason to do this. But in this case, I just needed to make a beautiful one-time visual to put inside of my report. So I'm going to show you over on our tutorial page how we create this chart right inside of Microsoft Excel using a scatter plot as the base. And then we have to do a little bit of hacking with some formulas to the X and Y values. So let's go over to the tutorial tab right here. Right here, you can see that I just have my ID column. I have one all the way through 50. That's 50 people. And then this is the stay time of each of those people, 1 through 50. And then right here, you can see I have an average stay time. And this is just a calculation. So I just typed equals average. And then I opened the parentheses. And then I just dragged my area all the way up, 1 through 50. And then it's going to give me an average rating. Now, you could do this with median as well. But I'm going to use average or mean for the time being. Now you can see this other column right here that's just called Y. And this is actually my Y value because I know I need to make it a scatter plot. So you know a scatter plot always has an X value and a Y value. In this case, the time is going to be our X value. We're going to have X the time along the X axis from 0 minutes all the way up to probably an hour. And then the Y value, we don't really have any other value for this Y value. So we just need the same number. And I'm going to show you what it looks like when we make this scatter plot. So I'm going to highlight this whole section right here. Just make sure those Y values are the same. I'm going to go up to the insert tab and we'll insert a scatter plot like this. Now you can see this is what it gives me by default. And let's just go up here so we can see the header columns, the headers of each column. Now, this makes a lot of sense because the Y value is 0.5 for all of them. So they're all along the same line, but these are my X values, all the different times. And what we want to do is create that jittering effect. So what we're going to do is first I'm going to actually bring this title. I'm going to do some little housekeeping here. Let's see here. We're going to say descriptive title. That's going to go in later. What I want to do here is get rid of the horizontal grid lines. We don't need those. And I actually want to play with the scale on this y-axis because I want this to be, I want that 0.5 line to be kind of in the middle of the horizontal or the vertical space there. So I'm going to go ahead and right-click and format axis. And I'm going to make the major grid line go to from 0.1 to 0.5. And when I do that, it's going to automatically update my maximum to 1. So there's a nice, you can see it's nice and symmetrical in the middle right there. Now I'm also going to get rid of my x-axis line. So I'm just going to go and say no line to that. And you can see my values are already 0 minutes all the way up to 1 hour, 60 minutes. So that's perfect right now. And I'm going to keep that. And we're going to keep the x-axis here just for a second. But at the very end, we're going to delete it because we don't need it anymore. So now what I want you to see Oop, one more thing. I want to make sure that the borderline is gone too. We always want to make sure that that borderline for the chart is gone. We don't need those in good data viz here. All right, so in this, all my lines, when I click on these, it's going to click on all the different markers that I have. But I actually want to create a new formula that will create this jittering effect so that all of these dots will kind of go slightly above 0.5 or slightly below 0.5. And we do that by creating a formula here. So in this column right here, I'm just going to say Y jitter. And what we're going to do is type in the formula. So we're going to first open by equal sign, and then I'm going to put my cell right here, and then I'm going to put a plus sign. We're going to add that value to a formula that we create. And this is what we're going to do. We're going to use a rand between formula. So type rand between. And what this formula does is gives you, it returns a very slight value between two numbers, a negative and a positive number that you define. So I'm going to open the parenthesis here. I'm going to say negative 5, comma, positive 5. So it's going to give me a number between negative 5 and positive 5. And now I need to divide by something big with a large denominator so that the value becomes very, very small. So let's go and start. Let's start with 60. And we can always update this as we go. So I'm going to go ahead and click enter here. And then I'm going to, you can see it's 0.53, and then I'm going to go ahead and copy. Let's move this just a little over the side so you can see. I'm going to copy. I'm going to put my cursor right here and double click, and it's going to fill all the way down. So there we go. Now it didn't do anything to my chart because my Y values are still pulling from this Y column right here. When I click the chart, you can see that the entire source data is selected, and now all I have to do is drag this column over. And there is my jittered dots. Those are so beautiful. Now, if I were to change the denominator here, like let's change to 100 and then copy all the way down, you can see they would get even closer together. Or if I change this to 10 and then copy this down, they're going to become a lot more spread apart. So I really like them to be a little bit closer to that 0.5 line. So what we're going to do is keep, I'm gonna actually go to 70 this time and have just a little bit more there. That was perfect, and copy that down. So that looks like a really nice jitter effect. Now what we need to do is edit the markers a little bit because there's still a lot of overlap between this. So you can't really tell that there's 50 dots right here. So let's go ahead and let's increase the size of each of the dots. So in this format data series menu, I'm going to go ahead, click on built in, and then it's on 5 points. So I'm going to go all the way up to 10 points. And then let's edit the fill color to this beautiful kind of turquoise blue that I have. And then we're going to edit the transparency to 50%. And then I'm going to make sure that the borderline is that same teal or aqua color. And now you can see a little bit through those. You can see each of the dots has some transparency, so you really get a nice sense of, you know, that there are a lot of overlapping dots here in this sort of section, but the Y value in this case doesn't really matter. We just want to be able to see more of them. All right, so now I have to add a dot for my average value, and you can see we already calculated that average value down here, right? So it's average here, and then another Y value there. So let's actually go ahead up into my plot right here, and we're going to add a new series of data by right-clicking and then click on select data. We're going to add series. I'm going to go ahead and click on the name. It's going to be average right here. I'm going to push enter. My X value is going to be the average value in this cell, and then my average or my Y value is going to be right here, 0.5, and I'm going to click OK. And if I go back to the plot, you'll be able to see a tiny little blue dot. You can barely see it, but it's right there. I'm going to go ahead and make it orange just so you can see it, and we'll make it size 10, and I'll fill it with orange. Now, if you wanted to, you could just leave this here and say the orange dot equals the average stay time there. But I want it to be that nice, really long, sort of thin average bar that we have right here. And we're going to embed that too. So the first thing that we could do is create this into the Insert tab and then go up to Shapes. I like the square with rounded corners. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to kind of position it with the number, with the size that I want it to be. Maybe be a little bit thinner. And then I'm going to go ahead with my outline. I'm going to outline it in white, and then I'm going to fill it with orange. Perfect. Now, if I really wanted to do this brute force, I could just put it right over here, and then voila, that's my average line. But I actually want to embed this, so I want to show you what to do here. So I'm going to go ahead and click save. I want to save this as a picture. Save it anywhere on your computer. And I already have this mean orange line that I already saved. So I'm going to go ahead and just close out of that. But once you save this picture, now you need to go back to your dot. You're going to right click, format the data series, go up here to the marker, fill, and then instead of the circle, we're actually going to go here to circle. And you're going to say from file, you're going to navigate to where you saved that orange marker line, insert, and there it is. Now you can still see that there's actually a blue borderline around this marker, around the line, so we want to go ahead and delete that. So go to back to the marker so that you can edit that out. Under the border, we're going to say no line there. And then I want to label this, so I'm going to right click and add data labels. Now it automatically gives me the Y value, but I want to unselect over here in the format data label menu. We're going to unselect Y, select X, and then I'm going to select the position above. So you can see that's my average. And then I'm going to actually select series name too. That'll give me my average stay time. And I'm going to go ahead under separator, instead of a comma, I'm going to do a new line here. And then you can edit this text to color, nice and bold. Perfect. And now what I can do is I can get rid of this y-axis, delete that, and that is how you create a beautiful jitter plot in Excel. Now all I would have to do is insert some text boxes to do those annotations for the minimum, the maximum. I would right click on these and add the data label for the minimum. If you click on one of the dots, it's going to highlight all of them. But then if you select it again, so kind of a double click on the same dot, that's going to isolate one of the dots. And then you can right click, add a data label there. I'm going to go ahead and reposition it so that it's above. And there's the uncheck Y, select X, and so there's my 3 minutes. That's my minimum. I would do that for the maximum as well. So I hope you like this tutorial. This is such a cool plot that packs a lot of information into one chart. It's so much different than just a normal bar chart. And in fact, there's some research that shows that people don't really understand what a bar chart means when you're trying to visualize an average. So it's really nice to be able to visualize every single person in your sample or every single response in your sample or something like that if you're doing this for like survey data. So I hope you like this chart. I hope that you, if you like this video, you'll give it a thumbs up. I appreciate all the likes and subscribes. If you subscribe to my channel, you'll get notifications each time I post a new video on data design, Excel, PowerPoint tutorials, all that good stuff. So thanks again for watching, and I'll see you next time.